students of class 10th. Today I am explaining few more questions of exercise 5.5. So open your book and see question number 39. The question is, the hotel bill for a number of people for overnight stay is ₹4,800. If there were four more, the bill each person had to pay would have reduced by 200. Find the number of people staying overnight. Now see over here on this board, total hotel bill is equals to ₹4,800. Let the number of people be X, each one's contribution equals to 4,800 divided by X. X is the number of people. If the number of people is increased by 4, then each contribution will be 4,800 upon X plus 4. Now, according to the question, if the number of people increase, then the contribution decreases. It means 4,800 upon X subtracted 4,800 upon X plus 4 equals to 200. Now, as you know that if the denominator of two fractions are not same, their product is the LCM. So X multiplied by X plus 4 is the LCM. Now we will multiply this 4,800 by X plus 4. We kept it over here. Then X multiplied by 4,800 over here equals to 200. Now if we open the bracket, 4,800 multiplied by X is 4,800X plus 4,800 multiplied by 4 is 19,200 minus 4,800 multiplied by this X is 4,800X. Now, because this is plus and this is minus, so these two will be cancelled. We have taken this 200 over here below this 19,200 equals to, and taken this X square plus 4X to the other side by cross multiplication method, and the equation will become X square plus 4x minus 96 equals to 0. Now this has converted into quadratic equation, and you all know that how to solve the quadratic equation. Solve it and get the value of X. Question number 41 in your book. Ritu bought a sari for ₹60x and sold it for ₹500 plus 4x at a loss of X percent. Find the cost price. Now here in this question, cost price is equals to ₹60x. Selling price is equals to ₹500 plus 4x. Because Ritu sold the sari at the loss, therefore the formula of loss is equals to, loss equals to CP minus SP. CP is 60x minus SP is 500 plus 4x. So we have put this value over here. If we open this bracket, because of this minus sign, this 500 will become minus, and minus plus minus 4x will come over here. Then if we subtract minus 4x from 60, we get 56x minus this 500. Now the formula of loss percent is equals, loss percent equals to loss upon CP multiplied by 100. And because it is already given in the question that loss percent is x, so we have put this x over here equals to loss, which we have taken out over here, 56x minus 500 upon CP, that is 60x, and multiplied by 100. Now if we 0 is here, we can cancel the 0 by the 0, and 10 and 6 can be cancelled by 2. 2 3s are 6 and 2 5s are 10. Now this 3 will be 3x will be multiplied with x by cross multiplication. 3x square will come equals to 56x multiplied by 5 is 280x minus 500 multiplied by 5 is 2500. Now we'll bring all these terms to this left hand side. 3x squared minus 280x plus 2500 equals to 0. Now this has become a quadratic equation. Now you can solve the quadratic equation to get the value of x. Whatever the value of x will come, you have to put that value over here. Then you will multiply 60 multiplied by the value of x to get the cost price of the sari. Now see question number 43 in your book. The question says, the age of a man is twice the square of the age of his son. 8 years hence, the age of man will be 4 years more than 3 times the age of his son. Find their present ages. Now see over here on the board. Let the present age of the son be x years. Then the present age of the man will be 2x square according to the question. After 8 years, the age of son equals to x plus 8 and the age of man will be 2x square plus 8 years. According to the question, the man's age is 4 more than 3 times the age of the son. So we have put the value over here. 2x square plus 8 is the age of man, which is equals to 3 times the age of the son plus 4. Now we'll open this bracket. When we open this bracket, we have to multiply both the terms by 3. 3 into x is 3x and 3x is 24. Now 2x square plus 8 equals to 3x plus 24 plus 4. Now we'll bring all these terms to left hand side. 2x square plus 8 minus 3x and 24 plus 4 is 28, which will be minus 28 over here. Now if we subtract this plus 8 from minus 28, we get minus 20. Now here the value of 2x square minus 3x minus 20 is equals to 0. As you know that when x square is having any coefficient, then we multiply this coefficient by the last constant number and find the factors to get to split the middle term. So 20 twos are 40, and if we split 40 in 8 and 5, it gives minus 3x. So we have divided, splitted this 3x into 8, minus 8x plus 5x minus 20 equals to 0. Then from these two terms, 2x is common. So we have taken x over here, minus 2x is already common from here, so 4 will come, plus 5 is common in these two terms, so we have taken 5, x is left over here, minus 5, 4 is 20, so 4 equals to 0 now. X minus 4 is common in both the terms, so x minus 4 is here, multiplied by this 2x plus 5 equals to 0. If you see, the product of two terms equals to 0, so either the first term is 0 or the second term is 0. If x minus 4 equals to 0, then the value of x is 4. And if 2x plus 5 equals to 0, then the value of x is minus 5 of form 2. And age cannot be in negative number. So this value will neglect. The value of x is 4. It means the age of son is 4 years. And then you can find out the present age of the man by this. 2x square. Put the value 4 over here. 4 square is 16. 16 to the 32, it means the age of man is 32.